Hello, everyone. Buckle up, because it's time for the state to enter the fray in hegemony. The state player is the most unique team in hegemony and adds a completely different dynamic to the game that the other three teams don't. The state has three companies to start, and they all provide services. They provide either education or health or influence. So when production happens there, their services go to the public services area where they're open for purchase for anyone to buy at any point. Additionally, for the healthcare and the education, there are political policies that impact how much each of those cost. So that can be a dynamic that changes as the game goes on as well. Later on in the game, it's potential that there will be companies that provide goods as well, and those would be the luxury and the food. And at that point, the state player will be able to have those on their board for sale. But at the beginning, they do not have that present for them. Also, when it comes to influence, there are two types for the state player. So when the influence is produced by the media, and in this case, the National Public Broadcast, when they produce for influence, those go onto the public services that can then be purchased by other players. But there are other ways for the state to gain influence, and whenever they're able to gain personal influence, they can put that on their player board as well for them to make use of during the elections. Now, for the elections, the state player does not have their own cubes in the bag to be pulled when the election happens. The other three players have cubes, so their totals will be added to the election, but the state does have its own influence, so they can influence the election by using those influence cubes to sway the election one way or another. The main feature of the state player and the state board are the three legitimacy tracks. So as the game goes on, the state is going to try to do whatever it can to make sure that it helps out the other factions. So whenever they do something that is going to be especially beneficial to those players, then they will make use of these tokens from the different colors, and they will be able to move those cylinders up the track, and in doing so, they will gain points. They will gain victory points toward their total. It's beneficial for the state player to help all three teams. If they help two of them and not one of them, they might be hindered in their final score. So as the game goes along, they are going to consider how they can help out the other players across the board to try to move up their own legitimacy track and gain more points. The first way that the state can impact legitimacy is through action cards. Some of the action cards have on the bottom the symbols for legitimacy. And so when you play the card and impact one or more of the classes, then the legitimacy changes to correspond with that. Sometimes there's a negative impact on legitimacy, and other times there is a positive impact. The second way that legitimacy can be affected would be due to events. So events are not used in the game when you don't use the state player, but there are going to be times where the events show up, and when you flip them over, you have to do what it says. So you have to choose two classes and provide 25 in cash to each of them. And if you don't do that, then you are going to get a negative on two of those. But if you do what the card says and pay 25 to two of them, and then you would get a positive point on the legitimacy track for the two that you gave the money to. So that is the second way that you can impact legitimacy. The third way would be if other players buy health or education from you for free. So in that case, the public policy of having the number four and number five at the A would make it so those were free. Anytime a player gets either one of these for free, where they get three of them, you would take their token on the legitimacy track and move it up one. So it benefits the state then to have the welfare state at A for number four and number five. In addition to the three ways that you can impact legitimacy that I just discussed, the last piece would be these legitimacy tokens that I just mentioned. So these tokens are gained with different actions that you can do throughout the game. And when you get one, not only do you get that initial additional legitimacy, but what they do is every turn they provide a permanent bonus where that next round you're going to get another one and then another one. So every round you gain plus one when you have these legitimacy tokens in front of you. So that's the player board for the state. Let's see how they play. There are four things that will happen during the preparation phase for the state. First of all, they need to pay interest on any loans that they have. The loans are for 50 in cash, and they have to pay 5 in interest for each loan that they have. Second is they need to reveal new events. So they will draw 2 new event cards and put them in the event locations. So 1, 2, and as I just mentioned in the discussion about the state player board, that you want to try to accomplish these goals to get the positive legitimacy from them. And if you do not accomplish them, then you get negative points. So those are going to be the things that the state is working toward during this round. The third thing is the political agenda. So the political agenda of this government will change from round to round. So these are cards that are unique to the state player. You flip one over and you want to accomplish these 5 political policies by the time that you get to the scoring phase. So you compare that to where the agenda is currently, and throughout the round, you're going to work to try to get as many of those to match up with the political agenda that's on the card. For each one that the actual policy is the same as the one on the card, the state player will get 1 victory point during the scoring phase. And finally, the state player will draw 5 action cards to replace any cards that they have spent during the round. Now, this preparation phase does not happen during the first round, but instead it will continue during the other 4 rounds. So we'll draw our initial 7, and let's just say, okay, if it was the preparation round, we would have 2 because we would have spent 5 of our cards, and we get 5 to replace. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to the 5 with our first 2 makes it so we have 7. So that's the preparation phase. A lot of things going on for the state. Let's move on to the action phase. During the action phase, there are passive benefits that the state might gain when other players take actions. If the other players buy health or education at 5 cash each, regardless of how many they get, whether they get 1 or 10, if they are paying 5, that means that the policy is B, you gain 1 victory point. If, on the other hand, the policy is at A and the other players buy those services for 0 for free, then whichever player that bought it, you gain legitimacy for that. But it's only if they buy 3 of their chosen good. Some action cards require the state to provide benefits to other players. If they do so, you would not give that to the players directly. Instead, you would put those benefits in the state benefits area. Now, this corresponds with other players because the other players have a receive state benefits action that they can take in that situation. If any players receive benefits, regardless of whether it's a small amount of benefits or a large amount of benefits, then the state player receives 1 victory point. The state has fewer action choices than the other factions, but the mechanics are the same. Basic actions require the player to spend a card. So if they have seven cards in their hand, they either have to discard one to get the basic action, or they can spend the card and use the card for the text that is on the card. Free actions, on the other hand, they get one of those each turn as well. So they get one basic action or card with text per turn and one free action per turn. And then every player has five turns in the action phase. So let's look at what these basic actions are. Proposing a bill. So if a player proposes a bill, they take their bill marker and they put it on the proposed policy. So when there is a political agenda, these players will want to consider what will benefit them. So for example, 2C is the agenda that's here. So the player would want to propose that, and the cylinder for the state is the gray one, and they would propose that bill there. If the state player wants to have an immediate vote, they can spend an influence to call that immediate vote. But remember that the influence cubes can also be used to add to the vote totals on one side or the other. So they are very valuable for swinging the election one way or the other. So be cautious when using the influence cubes for immediate votes. Instead, use them for actual votes in the elections, in the election phase, if it's more valuable to do so. The second basic action is the event action. So there are two event cards that are out on the table. And if you do one of these events and complete them, then you can get the benefit from them and discard it after you've accomplished it. The third basic action is to sell to the foreign market. If you have food or you have luxury goods, you can take those and you can sell them, and you can look at whatever the export price is and sell them at that price. The next basic action is to meet with a party's member of parliament. And in that case, you will give two of your own personal influence to another player, and they would have it available for them to use during elections later, but you would gain one legitimacy on the legitimacy track of the player that you gave it to. Next would be if there is a situation where you need money quickly, you can give extra taxes and get 10 from each other player. Then you would have to subtract one from each player's legitimacy track. The next basic action would be an extra tax, which would allow you to get 10 from each other player. If you do so, then you subtract one on the legitimacy track of the two lowest players. So this is one that players would likely want to avoid if possible. And then lastly, for basic actions, the state can campaign and move up to three media from the main board to your own player board. So instead of it being public where people can buy them, you would have that media as your own personal tokens available when it comes to election time. The free actions for the state are few. You can either adjust wages. So at your businesses, you can adjust the wages that are on your different businesses. If you raise the wages, you can commit the workers so that you know that you will get their production and you will be paying them wages. The other free action is to pay off loans. So you spend 50, you discard your loan, and it's gone. In the production phase, production happens where the services that are provided by the public sector go to the public services area. The storage in the public services area is whatever you are able to produce of that service plus six. So you can factor that in with the first row of companies, and if public policy changes, you might have other companies that are available to you. If by chance you get a hold of companies that allow you to produce luxury and food, you are able to keep that on your own board and decide whether you want to sell it to the foreign market or other players. Following up with that comment about food, during the cover needs portion of the production phase, other players may want to buy food from the state player, and that is perfectly legitimate, and you can sell it for the price of 12 that is there. The last part of the production phase is the pay taxes section, and the state loves this part because the state doesn't pay the taxes, the state collects the taxes. So all three other factions, they will take their tax money and they'll put it on the state treasury to be money that's available for the state to spend as necessary in future turns. One more important aspect for the state player during the production phase is IMF intervention. So during the production phase, if the state has more loans than what its fiscal policy allows and they're unable to pay them off, then the IMF will intervene. So comparing this on the table, okay, so you've got 1x on the C, you can have 2 for B and 2 for A. So that means you can have one set of loans for C, two set of loans for B, two set of loans for A. If you have more than that, then IMF is going to intervene. So what's the impact of that in that situation? So first of all bills proposed by any team, any faction are discarded. Each player who proposed bills gets one influence for each bill that they proposed that it ends up getting discarded. The politics table is going to be moved to these particular policies. So regardless of where they are currently, they move there. And then you apply the effects from all the policies that change due to the IMF's intervention. For example, 1C has 3 public companies. Well, if you were at 1A and that allowed you to have the other 6 public companies uncovered and available, well, all of a sudden these 6 have to be sold immediately, and then all the workers who were on there are going to become unemployed. So you have that immediate effect as one example. So you immediately have all of those effects from the IMF intervention. For the pay taxes portion, when the working class and middle class pay taxes, they're using the previous section for their taxes. They've already done their work. After these changes are applied, the state must pay off any loans that it has the money to do so. And once the state has paid off all the loans that it can afford, it will discard any remaining loans. Lastly, the state will move all 3 legitimacy markers on the board to half of their current total. At that point, the IMF intervention has ended and the players can move on. During the scoring phase, the state player does the following. First of all, you would apply event penalties. So during the course of the round, the state player did not accomplish both events, they would have to suffer the negative effect from the event that is still on the board. After the negative effect is applied, then any remaining events are discarded. The second part of the scoring phase for the state is to score legitimacy and adjust tracks. So you have 3 tracks for legitimacy. And while the highest legitimacy is nice, the scoring happens based on the 2 lowest legitimacy. So if you spend the entire game getting the working class up to 10, that doesn't do much for you if the other 2 are sitting down at 2. So then you would get 2 for each, so 2, 4. So a better strategy then would be to try to keep them fairly even. So maybe having something like this, where now your working class player legitimacy track is not as high, but the other 2 are higher. So now you get 4 plus 5 because you're adding up the 2 lowest legitimacy numbers. After you add up the 2 lowest numbers on the legitimacy track and get the victory points based on that, all of the cylinders need to be moved down to half, rounding up. So in this case, 6 will go down to 3, 4 will go down to 2, 5 would go down to 3. And then if you have any of these tokens, so let's say we've got a token for the middle class, that would allow you to move that cylinder up 1. The last part of the scoring phase is to check that political agenda and see what policies match up with what is on the board. So anything that matches up will get 1 extra victory point at this time. At the end of the game, there are final opportunities for each player to score some points. The first opportunity for the state player is to gain 1 victory point for each 30 that remain in the state treasury. So having more money in the state treasury is to the benefit of the state player. Secondly, they gain 1 victory point for every 2 food, 3 luxury, 3 health, 3 education, and 3 media in your storages, whether that storage comes on your board or in the public services area on the board. A few other important rules to note. First of all, if tariffs are paid by other players, take note that you are going to gain that money as the state player, so that will go to the state treasury. Second, whenever you provide items, again, do not give them directly to the player. Make sure that you put them in the state benefits area. And lastly, in the election phase, in the refill bag step, you gain influence instead of voting cubes based on your lowest legitimacy score. So another reason to try to have an even increase of legitimacy would be to get the benefit of those cubes. So you can see here, if you're at 3 as your lowest one, you only get 1. But if, say, you have this at 4 and these at 6, well, the lowest one is at 4, you get 2 cubes. If you had this up here, you would now have 3, and so on. If you're able to get all of them up to 10, that would get you 5 influence, which would be really important for winning the election. So that is the state player. Well, everyone else zigs, they will zag. They are going to have differing goals every round, and they are going to try to help all of the players throughout the game. So they are going to play a very dynamic, ever-changing game and have challenges presented with that, but also have a lot of opportunity as well.